Over Labor Day weekend, I ran into Lowe's to get some charcoal for the old charcoal grill. Cooking out some skirt steaks and some hot wings, okay? And I had a little time to kill, so I decided to walk down the air filter aisle. And there's so many air filters. And I've posted some things about the 3M Filtrete filter here recently. And it seems like a lot of people love that filter, which is, it's a great filter. I can't deny that. But I want to take a time and make a video here about what that filter is doing to the system. I would say 90% of the homes that we go into have undersized ductwork in my market. I can't speak for the whole nation. This is in North Texas. I have worked in Chicago as well. Very similar circumstance with stuff being undersized very frequently. DFW is my primary market. Houston, one of the most air-conditioned cities in the world. Also, very similar market to here in North Texas. But anyways, let's jump right into this thing. So I was amazed by, and I think this might be something new that Filtrete started doing. They actually publish the initial pressure drop across the filter, on the side of the filter now. Something I haven't seen in years past. I've never really looked in years past, but it's there now. So the 3M Filtrete, that's the purple or the blue one. That thing has a 0.43 inch of water column drop across the filter. So let me explain what that means to you. A filter, and you have a return duct or an intake vent, and it's taking air from your home, bringing it through this filter, through the unit, to get all conditioned and happy, and then go back throughout the home. Well, most systems that are single stage, they're designed or maximum rated static pressure is 0.5 inches of water column. 0.5. And this filter, before we have any static pressure added from fittings and grills and reducers and balancing dampers and coils and heat exchangers and everything else that goes into the system, this one filter is basically utilized the maximum rated static pressure for a system. I won't get too technical here, but static pressure is essentially like blood pressure for your heating and cooling systems, ductwork. The higher that number is, the lower your airflow will go. It's directly proportional. These are fan laws. This isn't something that I came up with, okay? So what I did at Lowe's the other day while I was shopping for my charcoal is I grabbed pretty much one of every filter that they had, different levels of them. I laid them all out on a shopping cart and created this video for y'all. I hope you enjoy it. First up to bat, we had Old Red. Red came in with an initial resistance of 0.43 inches water column. That's when the filter is clean. Next, Old Blue. Came in at 0.36. That was a surprise to me, actually. Next, Mr. Brown had 0.47 there. And the big boys, the 4-inch, leading the pack with an impressive 0.27.
Finally, we have the bird and rock catcher, which is good for nothing at 0.20. You can see right through this one. If you can see through the filter, particulates are going to get by it.
What is the problem with having high static pressures? One, most importantly for me, lack of comfort. You know, as static pressure goes up, airflow goes down. Catch more particulates, less airflow, less comfort. In an asthmatic or hyperallergenic home, that might be the best thing that you could ask for in your home. Great. So let's look at some of the other problems with high static pressure. Not just lack of comfort and poor airflow. What it's doing to the equipment. You know, I won't get into the formula. There's a long formula which essentially static pressure ends up being a multiplier in the equation of how efficient a system's true delivery of cooling or BTUs per hour is. We're not going to get into all that nonsensical technical jargon today, or probably ever in here. Our goal here is to keep things super simple for homeowners and technicians out there. So as static pressure goes up, comfort goes down, airflow goes down, but the life expectancy of your equipment is going to be diminished when airflow goes down. There's just so much to unpack here, folks. And, you know, I said earlier, 90% of the homes I go into, duct design is lacking. That's the whole reason why I'm creating a lot of the content I do, is to make it more common knowledge. The current methodologies to design ductwork are, frankly, impractical. And even when you have access to HVAC or the duct design load calculation software, in my experience, you know, sometimes they don't work as well as the more practical methods, which are included in some other videos. I'll include a link to my affordable kit video somewhere over there. Duct design is the number one killer of units out there. Number one. End of the day is this. I just want people to understand that if you are using a highly restrictive, let's call it high MERV, high particulate catching filter, just understand the repercussions on the back end of that, which are your equipment's gonna die sooner. That means blower motors, heat exchangers, capacitors, whatever. It's shortening the life. Just think of it as, you know, you're robbing Peter to pay Paul. Yeah, you'll catch more particulates, but you're not going to have the most optimal comfort in your home. Frequently people say, well, all of a sudden, you know, this room's hot all the time, or this room's cold all the time. Well, you recently changed the filter? Did you go with a very highly restrictive one? There you have it. in conclusion, I want to leave you with three things. Number one, choose your filter wisely. Look at the things like the pressure drop across. Know what size air conditioner you have. If you notice some of those numbers were lower, I was looking at the maximum. So get with me if you want some more direction on that. Try to be consistent with the style of filter you're using, meaning if you're gonna use the super restrictive one, always use the super restrictive one, especially if you have guys adding refrigerant or servicing it frequently. Because you know what? If you take out that super restrictive filter and you put in a super cheap filter, the refrigerant charge and everything is going to be all out of whack. Remember that. And finally, you know, whether you're a homeowner or a technician, I'm here for you. At HVAC Double Agent, you know, our whole philosophy is the Zig Ziglar thing. You know, help as many people as we can. You know, that's the best way to get what you want out of life. If you need help, whether you're a homeowner or technician, comfort advisor, wanting to learn how to design some better ductwork and explain the stuff better to customers, send us an email. It's info@hvacdoubleagent.com. Also, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. Subscribe to this channel. Like this video. And let's change the world, baby, one duct at a time.